Okay, Google Keep at its most basic is just for recording and organizing notes. They can have a title, and then there's a body. And if you want to go shopping and you just want to get some celery and some lettuce, because you're feeling really healthy, if you go down and you close this note, there it is, it's done. You have your first note in Google Keep. Now let's go back into this note and I'm going to explain some things that are going on here. You just left click on it, it'll bring it back up into the middle, make everything gray behind it. So it's saying, hey, we're focusing on this note. I'm going to let you format it. But you can't change the style of the text. It's not meant to be a word processor. It just wants quick notes. But some of the things that you can do with it that I do all the time when I'm using it is I can turn my list into a checkbox. So when you go and you accomplish some of these things, you can just check them off, then they'll move down to the bottom. And if we had a few more things on this list, so if you hover over one of the items, you get these six little dots on the left. Left click on that and just pull them into a different order. And then the celery belongs to the grocery. So hover over the six dots, left click on it. If you take this and you move it over to the right, do that to all the things that belong in the grocery and your list is going to look less cluttered. It's going to be easier to manage. So that's one of the nice features that Google Keep has that's built in. Okay, now that we've touched on the basics of creating a note, we're going to look at the different options on how to create them. So if I go back up to the input box that says take a note, you go over to the right. This is for the checkboxes, which we've just did. This is for inserting an image, which we'll circle back to in a minute. And this is for inputting a note with drawing. So let's left click on that and it goes full screen to the drawing app. I'm going to switch over to using my pen, but you don't have to. You can also use this with your mouse. But to toggle between the two, if you go to the three circles in the upper right hand corner and you want to say draw with touch, that's going to allow you to draw with your finger. If you leave that off like it is now and you put your finger on here and move it around, it pans the screen. It's a little bit harder to tell because there's no drawing on it. We're going to go in the upper left hand corner and we're going to look at these options that you have to add a note. And first we're going to look at these three different markers and what the difference is. And it's easy to think of these as progressing in order. So the one on the left is a consistent, thick, full color marker. The one in the middle fades a little bit as you draw, more like a real marker. And the one on the right is translucent all the time, just like a highlighter. So I'm going to pick the one on the left with my pen. And this drop down box is going to show you the options. We're going to use it in red, that's already selected, and we're going to do it with this size. So let's come down to the screen. That little red circle is the marker waiting for me to use it. And I'm just going to say hello. We'll try cursive. So when you look at this, you can tell it's a consistent red the whole time, right? And if that's what you want, then that's all you really need to use. If you want it to look a little bit different, let's go to the middle selection. And I'll come down to the bottom. We're going to say hello there. You see this one just kind of faded at the end. It was a little bit lighter. And that's going to look more like if you're drawing on a whiteboard. And then the last one is meant to be a highlighter. So let's pick yellow so that we can tell. And we'll come down to the canvas. And we will just highlight the E in hello. And we'll pick an E in this and highlight that as well. So those are your three options for drawing on the screen. Between the three of those, I think you probably can find what you want. And this is just to put a background image on them to kind of see how things line up, to give it a little bit of texture. If we just do the dots for fun, it makes the screen look cool. Could be kind of useful. If you want to try to draw straighter lines, you can use those dots to align what you're doing. If you don't like anything that you did, you can either clear the entire page with this drop down by the eraser, or just select the eraser and come down here and I'll use my pen and I'm just going to redraw over that and you see it selects the entire line. So this part in the hello that I wrote all at once, if I tap on that, it's going to get rid of the entire thing. You also have a selector here if you want to select an entire area and do something with it. It makes a box. I don't know how often you would use that part, But let's say this is my note. Okay, so because this is really useful information, obviously everyone wants a note like this. And you can just go back and it'll save your note. And here it is. If I click close right now, it'll just consist of that. If I want to title this, we can do that as well. So let's say this is to do tomorrow. Hopefully I can read it. Otherwise, I'm not going to get very much done tomorrow. And we'll go in the lower right-hand corner and close it. And you have another card. So we've created two cards, one by just typing and one by using a drawing. Okay, so there are some features in Google Keep that are only available mobile. So I've brought my phone up onto the screen. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to use my mouse for a second here. I'm going to use the option in the lower right-hand corner, which accesses my camera, which wasn't there on the desktop. I'm going to click on that. And then I'm hovering over this receipt from FedEx office. Just simply take a picture of it. And it makes it into a note on my phone. Right now, I'm just going to click the arrow in the upper left-hand corner to save the note. And then I'm going to go back into my desktop because I don't see this option on my phone. The note has appeared here because my phone's connected to the internet and so is my laptop. So I'm going to left click on it. This is a picture of the receipt, and a hidden option here that shouldn't be hidden because it could be really helpful is to click on the three dots, left click on them, and grab the image text. It just instantly reads that receipt and it spits out just about everything that's on it. And it looks like it did a pretty darn good job. I went to the FedEx store earlier today because the laptop that I usually use with the 4K screen is broken, so I'm shipping it off to Hewlett Packard to fix it. And this is all the information. If you want to track my package, go for it. So scanning the receipts is very helpful if you want to enter it into a piece of software, possibly, or if you get someone's business card, you can scan it in. Let's go ahead and close this note now, and you'll see it's an image. And it has the text showing on the card that we just input. And another option for taking notes that's on a phone, probably a tablet, but it's not on the laptop, is the voice. So if you click on the microphone and you just say something, it'll take that note as well. It recognizes speech and it turned that into text. So if I press play, it also recorded my voice for you so you can hear it. One more way that you can take a note in Google Keep is to put a web address in here. So if you find some boots that you really want, let's copy that web address. I just copied this text, go into Keep, left click on take a note, put it in there and close it. It's smart enough to create a card from it, and if you give it a minute, it's going to take the title of the web page. See, up here it says Women's Boots. Here it says Women's Boots, and it'll just make a note that easily. And when you go into search, that's one of the items that you can just search for. If you think, oh man, I saved this link the other day, but I can't remember what it is. If you just search for URLs and search for boots, it'll bring that up. Okay, so I went into Google Keep. I put some different types of labels in here because now I've shown you how to put notes in, and we're going to go into how to organize them. I just did all text notes here just to not be distracting, and it was frankly faster to do it that way. First, we're going to go over coloring. So I have some notes in here that may apply to my job, and I'm going to color all of those green because that's how I make money. And then I have some notes in here for a hobby that frankly uses my money. So let's say that's red because it's money going back out. And then I have a bit of a shopping list in here. And so let's make that the color of pizza crust, of course. What else would you do? And then here's what I need to do to undo the pizza, which would be to work out. And it's going to make me sweat, which is the color of water. And you can just tell visually what goes where. And as I come in and look at this screen, I've colored everything, but you can get a lot more granular on how you organize by using labels. And if you look at the left-hand side of the screen, there's no labels yet. You can create them here, But the way I'm going to show you, I think, is a little bit faster. It's not quite as intuitive. You could also left click on these three dots and add a label. But what we are going to do will allow you to add multiple labels. So first, as we discussed, this is work. And take your mouse down and click on create work. That just made that label, but we're also going to say that this is something that you would read at night. And we also want to apply that label to it. And we'll see why in a second. So this is work at night. If it were me, I would probably come back in here and delete this text when you're done just because it's ugly, but we'll leave them there for now. The AI CPA is work. But it's a little bit more exciting, so I would say I would read this during the day. Click that on my mouse to add that label and close. And socks is something that I do at work. But I don't look at that at home at all. I don't read about it, so that's just going to stay at work. Then the drill is something that I want, and it's shopping. But the table saw, oh, those are great. That's actually something I need. Close that, we'll do the hammer. Now that you have these tags in here, and remember you can go back and delete the text if you want, if you find that kind of ugly. Just make it AICPA, but it keeps the labels. You can figure out what you want to do at night and what you want to do while you're at work, or what you should do when you're working out. And this is all driven by the labels, and having more than one gives you the ability to really have different views and different ways of thinking about the same list. So now that we're done with that, let's just go back to the notes view, which shows you all of your notes. And let's talk about the ability to pin these. And when you hover over one of them, you see the little thumbtack in the upper right-hand corner. If you click that, or if you press it with your finger, it brings it to the top. And what at least I use this for is to signify your high priority items. You really need to read about the AICPA today. Just pin it to the top. You'll see it first and won't get lost in the details. So let's just pin two of them. This is my priority for the day. If I get through that, then I can look into some of these. There's two different things to do with these when you're done with them. You can archive them, which similar to Gmail, it just takes them off of your screen, takes them off of your radar, but it saves the label in an archive where if you search for it later, you'll find it. Or if you left click on the three dots and you just want to get rid of it, just delete it. And another powerful way to work in Google Keep is to create a reminder. So if you want to buy a drill, but you know you're not even going to think about it until next month, come down to the lower left-hand corner. Tell Google Keep to remind me. Well, we'll just say next week. Left click on next week. And after you add it as a reminder, you can archive it so it'll drop off your screen. And then when it becomes next week, you'll get a notification that it's come up again and it will show in your notes. But now if you want to see it, you just click on reminders. This will tell you when it's going to pop up again. And all of your reminders will be here if you use that feature a lot. That'll help you get rid of some of this clutter, because if you use this product a lot, you're going to have 30 notes and you're not going to want to look through them all. Since this is a Google product, the other thing that you can do that works really well is just left click in the search box, type in drill. You can find it this way. I'm going to close that note. Let's take a look at what happened when I left clicked in the search box. If you don't type anything in yet, it will allow you to search by. And that's all. So Google Keep is relatively simple. The interface doesn't have a lot of options, and that's what makes it useful, in my opinion. If you don't want something that feels like Microsoft Outlook and you really have to manage the dates and move things around all the time, check out Google Keep. You might like it. And if you like this tutorial and you want to see others just like it, you can subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.